The fact that there are very few women in tech, and especially in the data science and software engineering fields, is no longer news anymore. According to the 2020 Global Gender Gap Report, 26% of computing-related jobs are held by women. While the number of women in the industry is actually growing, it's not growing fast enough. At this current rate, it will be another, let's say, 20 years before the number of women in tech makes up as much as the number of men. Females are less likely to pursue STEM degrees. There's already pre-existing gender gap in STEM program enrollments. And with computer science and coding knowledge being perceived as a requirement, many females may assume they're not really qualified for any role in the IT industry. Gender bias is another factor that leads to lack of awareness about the tech profession or lack of encouragement to go down the path. This is prevalent in STEM careers. When one searches top degrees for women, engineering, technologies, and computer science degrees aren't even on the list. Psychologists have actually attributed this to the fact that oftentimes, females' abilities in math and science topics are downplayed. While many women decide to learn code later on in their careers, it's an option that should have been available to them much earlier on. In addition to that, it's imperative that more is done to show young women that there's a spot for them in tech. At JENGA School, we are bridging this gap by ensuring 50% of our students are female. Is this all we can do? No. But it's a good start. We are not where we need to be when it comes to attracting women to the tech industry. The path to a reduced gender gap starts with all of us in the industry. There's so much more to tech roles than meets the eye, and it's important for young girls and women to know that there's a seat for them at the table, that they are successful women in the industry, excelling and finding joy in their careers, and that can be them too. At JENGA School, we have a big, hairy, audacious goal of ensuring we have 50,000 women in tech by 2030. Being in a position as the CEO to champion this cause that is bigger than me is exhilarating. Truly, the future is female and tech.